Good morning, Shalom, Docker Tov. Like Monica, my spoken English is bad because when I work in my home, I work alone and I don't speak English with my computer. I write emails, I read documents and publications, but my relations is with my computer. Well, today I want to talk about cyber SWAT. It's a concept, but how the law enforcement can conduct cyberspace operations. I would like, it's the note, my notes, I would like to express my thanks for all the attention and the professionalism of the INSS and CSFI, Paul, Hadas, Gabi, and the people in charge of organizing the conference, but especially to Gabi Siboni for the trust that he placed in me. And also to Mark Jamieson, the past year we defined the cyber SWAT concept talking together in the Tel Aviv beach. And also to the Spanish Civil Guard, is the paramilitar law enforcement agency that in Spain is the most valued institution for the Spanish citizens. He brings me the opportunity to learn working for them. I want to talk about the law enforcement situations that will need to change, what happened outside the cyber domain or inside the cyber domain, the cyber SWAT and why we need a cyber SWAT, some examples and the typical conclusion. Well, law enforcement. The law enforcement agencies have no autonomy on acting or investigating an ongoing cybercrime. The legality which protects normal police action in the kinetic world and in the streets should be also applied to the cyber domain. Every day, the complexity of investigations increases. One of the main objectives, which is to identify and locate the criminal, this is a problem which is becoming difficult to solve. Very difficult to solve, and now there are VPNs, Tor proxies. Well, this is a problem which is becoming every day very difficult to solve. The most, but for in the typical cyber cops unit, at the end, the most conclusive evidence are expected to be obtained in the suspect house by the means of the entry, searching, confiscation, and posterior analysis of the computer and devices in a forensic analysis. After the entry in the suspect house. Situations that will need a change. Police forces are just competent in their respective national jurisdictions on a geographical location. But well, cyberspace, the cyber domain, not have geographical limitations, and the approach to combat the cyber criminals is a bad approach because the cyber criminals are limited by geographical locations. An investigation that goes beyond the national territory are confronted with a lack of collaboration from services and companies that operate online. For example, for the Spanish police, to request information about Twitter accounts or another details of maybe Facebook accounts is a challenge because we need a court order, an international protocol, very complex, and investigations can durar. Last? Well, voy a aprender inglés. Last many years, no? An investigation that goes beyond the national territory also finds a coordinative and bureaucratic challenge from a police and judicial nature which makes it more complex and every day more complex. Outside the cyber domain, well, the police that works in the streets, the police that works in a kinetic wall, act with more autonomy and with a greater operative capacity in order to pursue and investigate crimes without being completely subjected to external collaboration. Eh? Act and intervene with an immediate effect in front of a certain crime, which amongst other possibilities permit the SWAT operations. If a police, a cop are walking in the street and see a window and in the window a child is abused, this cop can tumbar la puerta. Can broke the door and act. And don't need a court order or a warrant. Carry out an entry and search without a warrant. Well, one thing. It's my first presentation in English, and I never speak in English. But, well, carry out... Okay, thank you. Carry out an entry and search without a warrant before a flagrant crime, which is an evident limitation of one of the most sacred fundamental rights of the citizens, the inviolability of the home. Without a warrant, which is an evident limitation of one of the most sacred fundamental rights of the citizens. When people in the internet talk about the privacy, blah, 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 well, you understand me. Inside the cyber domain, the legality which protects normal police action should be also applied to the cyber domain in order to let the police to be able to act with a greater autonomy, which will allow them to act and intervene with an immediate effect in front of a certain cybercrime, which permit the development of cyber SWAT operations. Carry out a cyber entry and search without a warrant, before a flagrant crime. And one thing, an entry and search in a kinetical wall, maybe the major is a business, is you have a business, your business can be stopped? Is there, puede ser parado, stopped? Okay. But a cyber entry can be a silent entry and with no damage and can be used with a judge to investigate and well, is a good procedure, no? Which in addition could be protected, but and then also which in addition could be protected before the urgent necessity of intervention in order to obtain evidences that are suitable to disappear. The volatility of registers, locks, can be protected the cyber SWAT operation. Cyber SWAT. The cyber SWAT should be an elite unit that transfers and applies the capabilities of military scope cyber warfare in order to combat and pursue cyber criminals. In the kinetic world, there are the typical police units, and there are the SWAT units that can act in front of urgent and complex crimes, no? In order to combat and pursue cyber criminals. Okay. Before retained information which should be liberated in order to solve a cyber crime. in slides that we see in a few minutes, I can explain this concept, retained information. In the counter-terrorism operations and counter-national and transnational organized crime, and to assist in the lawful intercept unit force, specifically to deploy software on target criminals' computers. Some examples. The German Federal Criminal Police Office, the Country Domestic Intelligence Agency, and the Federal Police have deployed spyware onto the hard drive of suspected criminals. On January of the 2010, a subject then used encrypted mail service led the Nuremberg Code to prove the use of computer surveillance in the context of remote control. Investigators then deployed the software onto the suspect hard drive, presumably via an email attachment. They read emails he had sent in encrypted form. They recorded his cell phone conversations via Skype, and they took application shots that allowed them to monitor what the weightlifter was doing on his computer in real time. After 13 days, investigators had enough evidence to arrest the suspect. 13 days, remember. Well, operation against organized pedophilia. In the 2002, Boilover.net was launched. Boilover.net was one of the world's largest online boilover communities. In the 2007, the UK Child Exploitation and Online Protection opened their investigation. And then, in the 2008, the Spanish Civil War opened also their investigations, but the court, which did not consider that a crime exists, given that there were no explicit images on the public forum. The intervention of the court, which did not, the intervention of electronic mailboxes was also registered. However, in the case, no signs of crime were perceived from another country authorities either. Some months after the operation has started by the Guardia Civil, the UK Child Exploitation and Online Protection leads a operation that the joint forces of law enforcement agencies of some countries. In the October of 2009, administrators and moderators were arrested, but were arrested after an entry and search of the home of these suspect criminals. And then, in December of 2010, Boilover was taken. Arrests in various countries were made. In the March of 2011, information was released to the media. Global raid should Boilover.net arrest 184 men and rescue 230 kids. One, two, three, four years. Well, 4 years. 4 years to conduct this operation. Very lack of international support at the to manage the operations. The UK can manage the operations before there are good relations with the US authorities. But at the end, remember that no evidence of a criminal was the reason for the judge not give the warrant on entry search. Well, this is the forum, the boilover.net. This is not a museum, an artist. It's a forum that share histories about pedophiles that travel to Thailand, etc., etc. This is not an artist's pictures. And well, the calendars that I remember, I sometimes use a Playboy calendar or calendars. Woman's Secret have a calendar, but this calendar maybe are usually used like sexual motivation. No evidence. 2004. Well, no evidence. The harsh reality is that from 2002 until 2010, a pedophile organization was operating, increasing in followers and abusing children. At the time of Voiloiver was taken down, it had over 70,000 members. This is not the case of one internet forum, but of 230 abused children. No problem. Tres, four.
We negotiate. Okay.
In order to carry out their mission, law enforcement agencies and legislators must search the more efficient mechanisms to combat these criminals. Cyberterrorism and anti-system groups. One of the main uses that terrorists or anti-system groups make of the net is of the communication platform to communicate and claim their actions, and/or attacks, distributing propaganda and achieving the recruitment of followers so they can be integrated in their organizations. Well, Monica was talking about Black Bloc. He showed the capacity of the Spanish football team, the same capacity that we have in the cyber domain. But well, this is the Black Bloc Twitter. This Twitter link to a video that is on the YouTube, and you can see a Black Bloc Brazil that say, bombas do napalm, napalm bombs, homemade, and their production. No? Well, curious. The Black Bloc in Brazil are a movement, but is a radical movement, very aggressive, that in a riot in the streets, in a strikes, they use cocktail Molotov against the police that are working in the streets. Not are only politicians, guys that want make politicians propaganda. There are a very active acting group and aggressive group. This is a Twitter account. This is the Facebook account. The Facebook account have, I remember, maybe 60,000 members or likes. This is how this group plan finish. Demonstrates their plan to manifestarse in la calle.
Demonstrate.
Okay. How can, for example, they say that the power supplies in the Rio can be a problem. And well, it's probably that one of their targets will be the power supplies. Yeah? This is another example that how can works in the streets against the police operations, small groups, tactics. No, you can see their tactics and that are military tactics. This is a communicate of a small bomb that attack a power supply in the balneario in Brazil. It is evident that the following should be carried out: change legislation to include cyber operations and regulate cyber SWAT units. The legislation must permit more autonomy to investigate cyber crimes, with the purpose of achieving the trial of the cyber criminals, but also acting as a fundamental deterrent method. If you show that you have a SWAT, the only, for example, the riots in the streets cannot be investigated with units in the streets. These guys use masks, and these guys use smartphones. You can investigate and work against these criminal actions in the streets working on the cyberspace. And at the end, the cyber SWAT can be a very valuable unit and a deterrent method. If you can explain to your citizens that their movements and tactics that they use typical tools, online tools, can be searched and persecuted. Well, sorry for my English. And now you have any questions? Okay, sorry.
I can talk to you on the break.
Okay, toda.